Hey, I'm Robert, and I teach deep learning here at SAS. Today, I'm going to talk to you about an unsupervised learning method called autoencoders. Now, there are several different variants of autoencoders. There's denoising autoencoders and sparse autoencoder, but you may be wondering, what is an autoencoder? Well, an autoencoder is a neural network where you have inputs on your input layer and you have inputs on your output layer. Your mathematical neurons that are in your neural network are referred to as encoders or decoders. And all these are just probabilistic representations of the input space. So each of your mathematical neuron is gonna take a look at that input space and try to reformulate it again, given the input space. That's why inputs are on your input layer and inputs on your output layer. The idea or our hope when we use an autoencoder is to desensitize the irrelevant and sensitize the relevant. So I had mentioned that there's two variants that we're going to look at, a denoising autoencoder and a sparse autoencoder. And these are complicated names that really describe simple ideas. A sparse autoencoder is an autoencoder where we're going to constrain the objective function using an L1 or L2 regularization. That's all it is. For a denoising autoencoder, we're simply applying dropout to the input layer of our model. Let's take a look at this. So here I'm using SAS Studio, and the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to upload my images, then I'm going to view my images, and I'm going to view a subset of each of the classes. The data that I'm using in this example is the MNIST fashion data, where I have 10 different outcomes. Next, I'm going to resize the images to be a 32 by 32. Because of my input layer, I've specified that the images are 32 by 32. I could have just used the 128 by 128 if I wanted. I then partition the data and shuffle the data per good practice. If I look at the results, I can see the 10 different outcomes, that is the 10 different pieces of clothing or types of clothing that we're going to try to model. I navigate to the second program where I've created my sparse denoising autoencoder model. This is actually a convolutional sparse denoising autoencoder. It's convolutional because we're modeling images and we're using pooling layers and convolutional layers and so forth. So we begin by specifying our build model action, where we're going to create the model titled sparse denoise auto C, auto in for autoencoder. The type is going to be a CNN. All this does here, this build model, is it just builds a model shell that we're going to populate with layers. Next, we've got this add layer action where we're adding an input layer. So after the layer equals, when we have these curly braces, we're specifying the options for our layer. And this layer is an input layer. These are grayscale images, so they only have a single color channel, width of 32, height of 32. And notice I'm applying the dropout. This creates the denoising autoencoder. Just a fancy name to describe a relatively easy idea. So we're gonna drop out about 40% of the inputs every mini batch. We're just gonna randomly select 40 of the inputs and remove them from the modeling process. Next, we add our first convolutional layer. And this convolutional layer is gonna start with 16 neurons. The next convolutional layer is going to have 8 neurons. And notice that in this convolutional layer, we're actually applying batch normalization. And when you use batch normalization in SAS, you're actually adding a second layer. It's adding a second layer, but they're really the same layer. This first layer here, this add layer, this is a convolutional layer. And we know that because type equals convo with 8 filters. Notice that the activation function is identity. So this first add layer statement here is just really combining the inputs. We're not applying a nonlinear transformation as of yet. We then pass the information from this layer at line 24 to this next layer where we're going to normalize the information with batch normalization and then apply our nonlinear transformation. If you have any questions about batch normalization, definitely check out our other YouTube video. We then pass this information to our center layer, our center encoding layer, where we only have one convolutional filter. And then we expand the information back out using transpose convolutional layers. That basically upsamples the information until we arrive at our last convolutional layer. and then our final output layer. Now to train an autoencoder in SAS, in the DL train action, you just negate specifying a target. So notice in this code here, there is no target statement. But if you're looking at the code, you may realize that I have specified an L1 regularization and an L2 regularization. So in this example, we are creating a sparse, denoising, convolutional autoencoder. Sounds fancy, but it's really pretty simple. I'm going to train this model by running this code. We'll build the model structure, then train the model, and print out the output below. So now that the results have appeared, let's scroll down to the bottom. And we have an iteration plot showing our training performance, the blue line that seems to be monotonically improving, and our validation and performance. So I hope you liked this video where we looked at how to train autoencoders in SAS, and we actually looked at several variants, a denoising autoencoder, a sparse autoencoder, and we combined the two to create a sparse, denoising, convolutional autoencoder. Thank you for watching. Check out the links below for more information. Please leave your comments and questions and I'll get back to you. And if you'd like to see more of these videos, definitely subscribe to our channel. Take care.